Hey, Paul.
Dee, what's up?
How are you, man?
Good. Now, I've waited so long to personally thank you for having our TV removed from the dining room back in the 80s.
No more MTV! No more Twisted Sister! Gung Ho.
Oh.
Sorry, it was a little Gung Ho reference. Yeah, man. Well, I did what I could.
My dad was so angry when he first saw your video. We were eating a hot spaghetti dinner in the middle of the summer. He picked the TV up, wheeled it outside, and said it was not allowed to come back in the house. You specifically.
What is that? Wipe that smile off your face. Beautiful, man, beautiful.
Well, I mean, he was a guy, grew up in the 50s with the rockers and Elvis Presley, and he wasn't used to what he was seeing. But, he now is a fan, so.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting. It was culture shock for some people, even my father-in-law, who hates singers, as he calls me, he's a singer. So he loves me now too. And you see, if you stay around, Alice Cooper said, you stay around long enough, people get used to you.
Well, that's interesting that you bring him up too specifically because kind of in the same horror genre, but you did something completely different with it, and it's been really interesting to watch what you've done in your career because you produce some really cool stuff just even outside of the music.
Well, thanks. I've done a quite a few things, but in the horror world, I have a connection. I'm credited with creating the torture genre of horror films. My movie Strangeland reinvented the wheel back in '97 and inspired movies like Saw and Hostel and that whole new generation of horror filmmakers. I hosted a horror radio show for a few years on SiriusXM called Fangoria Radio, and now Holliston has got the horror connection because it's on FearNet, which, by the way, to find out how you can get subscribed to FearNet, please call 1-877-FEAR-247, okay, or go to fearnet.com. But they FearNet has all horror films on it, but they've got original content as well. And Holliston is a traditional sitcom in the vein of Friends. But the two lead actors, they're two young guys dreaming of being horror filmmakers. But by day, they work in a cable station. That's where they run into me, Lance Rocket, their boss, who by night is in a Van Halen tribute band called Diver Down. And I walk around in full makeup, hair, costumes, spandex, the whole nail polish, the whole 80s regalia. Because for Lance Rocket, the 80s is alive and well.
Well, now let me ask you about Van Halen because they were big back in the 80s too, and I'm wondering if there's a history there with you and that band, why that band specifically was chosen for the show.
You know what? I have no idea. That writer creator Adam Green, that's what he chose. I never even asked him why Van Halen. But what's pretty funny about that is that this year is season two, mind you. So Siri, you got this guy in his 50s who still thinks he's going to make it by playing in a tribute band. So now this year I've got my stuff together and I've decided I'm not going to make it playing Van Halen songs. So now I'm playing original Van Halen songs. And I write my first original Van Halen song called Love It Down Your Throat. And later this season, you'll see Diver Down's first rock video, Lance Rocket's first rock video for Love It Down Your Throat.
That's too funny. So now I have to go explain to my dad that he should probably quit the Twisted Sister cover band that he does down there in Oregon. He's just never going to make it.
Now, yes, you're never going to make it. Give up. It's over, man. It's over.
Now, I want to know about this animated episode that you guys have coming up. How cool is that for you guys to have something like that in a show like this? A little bit different than what we normally see.
Well, okay. I've seen the animated episode. Cool. But on the plus side, they made my genitals very big in the spandex. But they also made my nose equally big. So I would appreciate a smaller nose and keep the big genitals. That said, in that episode, there is some live action. In that episode, I do my first nude scene. They come back to work. I don't want to give too much away. Lance, who's a very sexual guy, he didn't think anybody was going to be coming to work. And so he has a tryst in his office with some interesting characters and animals. And I do this whole scene where I'm just wearing high heels, face veil and makeup, and have a fan in front of my Johnson. So a big fan. as a very big fan in front of my Johnson. The really great part about that was the day my son decided to bring my grandchildren down to see Grandpa work. So here I am standing on the set doing my first nude scene with my fan in front of my Johnson, and all you wear is a little beige, like, brief, you know? And my two grandchildren come in to see Grandpa.
So now that to be an interesting take your kids to the work day there.
Yeah, that's going to be an interesting few sessions in therapy when they're teenagers. That's what I think. I think I've got some more therapy bills to pay.
But now I want to say I saw that Bill Moseley and Dave Naughton, they're coming on horror icons. What about music icons? Are there any guest stars from that realm coming into the show?
You know, that's a good question. Other than myself, which is really more than enough, so far they haven't cluttered things up. Holliston, I mean, it is on Fearnet, and it does tip its hat to the world of horror in a big way. But I like to say to people, you do not have to be a horror fan to enjoy this show, just like you didn't need to be a heavy metal fan to enjoy Spinal Tap, or you didn't need to be, work on a television news show to enjoy Anchorman. There might be some inside jokes that these people will get more than others, but anybody can watch any of those shows and enjoy them. And Holliston is a real traditional sitcom. It's funny, it's entertaining, it's got great story, great character, and a lot of heart.
Well, now you said that you're more than enough in terms of The Rock, but the guy from GWAR is still on the show, is he not?
Oops. Yeah, I forgot. He's in a band. Yes, Odorous. All right, edit that. There's other rockers on the show. Odorous Humongous is on the show as well from GWAR, a fine musician. And, yes, he plays Adam's invisible friend who lives in the closet, and which is very funny. Odorous is very funny. GWAR is very funny. So Odorous is on there.
Now, did you say you forgot he played music?
Yeah. I don't tell him. I don't really know GWAR. I mean, I know of them, but I don't really know their stuff.
No, that's funny. Well, that's the thing is Twisted Sister fans sit and watch GWAR video come on, and then that's when they wheel the TV outside.
Well, you know what? I mean, Dave Brocky, who is Odorous Humongous, one of the first things he told me was what a huge fan of my stuff he was. So, I mean, really, GWAR just, like, you know, saw me and my craziness and said, well, let's take it one level crazier, you know, and they went, you know, so he devised his costume. And they're brilliant, and GWAR's brilliance is their comedians. And their songs are funny, their act is funny, and they're fun. And he brings that comedy in a great way. That persona of Odorous is just brilliant.
No, that's funny. Now, I want to know, did you create the Van Halen song yourself, or was that created by the writers?
Yeah, this is all they're doing. You know, it's funny because I really thought I was going to be just making fun of all those 80s wannabes, and pretty much I'm only making fun of myself. But, yeah, they wrote the song. We shot a video for it, Love It Down Your Throat video, which is like the worst 80s hair metal video. I know people are just going to say, hey, D's got a new video out. So I'm trying to do a spoof, and people are just taking it seriously. So, you know, but I'm having fun.
Well, and last question, is that going to be available for me to go buy on a record?
Oh, that, you know, I'm sure it's going to be downloadable. I know for a fact, I've seen the episodes already, and at the end of that episode, you can see where you can download the video and the song "Love It Down Your Throat." And it's a really good song. Actually, Adam Green, the writer creator of the show, he wrote "Love It Down Your Throat." He used to play in an '80s band when he was a kid. He was a big Twisted Sister and GWAR fan. So for him, this is like a dream come true. He's got some of his heroes literally on the set of a story about his young life.
Okay, hey man, it's so great to get to talk to you.
Pleasure, Paul.
And can't wait for Strangeland 2. I know you've been working on that, right?
Yeah, well, it's on and off. It's been on and off and on and off. It's one of a heartbreaker for me. But right now it's off. Who knows if it'll ever be on? By the time it gets on, probably Captain Howdy will be using a walker, which is not quite as threatening.
No, the fans want it, so, I mean, I'm a fan.
Captain Howdy in one of those little scooters, those electric things riding around. Yeah, it's going to be great.
That might be awesome, though. That hasn't been done.
He's after me. He's after me. He's after me.
I've never seen a movie in an old folks' home.
Let's do it. Paul, let's do it. Let's make that movie.
I will. I will definitely do that.
It's Cocoon meets Nightmare on Elm Street.
Yeah.
It's going to be great.
Nightmare in Heaven's Half Acre.
Exactly.
Okay. Well, hey, thanks so much. I'll talk to you later.
Take care, man.